The Light Warden is dead. The Blessed's prayers have been answered.
Aye, that they have.
His condition yet troubleth thee?
It does. Though he shows no immediate signs of corruption, the danger remains. He must be told. Would you describe it to me, Marie-Angers? Paint for me a picture with your words.
A sea of shimmering stars. Diamonds strewn across a raven gown, boundless and beautiful. 'Tis an exquisite sight, not unlike that of the source, calm and gentle and forgiving.
I can see it.
For however deep the void or wide the expanse, there is no shore so distant as to be beyond the reach of light. Ominous though that may sound, given our present travails.
Well fought. Let us return home. If I'm not mistaken, they predate the Empire.
How can you tell?
A peculiarity of the paint. Most are made from mineral-based pigments, but whatever was used here is older than anything I have ever seen. According to Almut, this sanctuary was built to preserve the wisdom of the ancients. What events do these murals commemorate, I wonder?
Must you always linger after defeating your enemies? Navigating these halls on foot is exhausting.
Come to lead us to safety, have you?
I was bored. But how is the hero of the hour? Fighting fit, I see. Keep up the good work.
You're plotting something.
Every hour of every day. But never you mind about that. As I have told you 1,000 times before, I like to watch. Nothing more.
Well, I would quit this place and I suggest you do the same. There is yet work to be done.
Is a sight to bring a tear to the eye.
You recognize these scenes?
That I do. Indeed, there was a time when anyone and everyone would. Until one calamitous day when the world was divided across 10 and 3 reflections. Sundering the land and all who dwelled upon it. And the worst part? No one could remember it. Not really. Just fragments and fleeting memories of an achingly familiar world. A vision shared of a paradise lost, preserved only in song and scripture and paint. Once upon a time. Yet here we find ourselves again, to look, learn, and remember.
Then share with us the stories you know so well. We are listening.
Before the Great Sundering, there was one world. A world that knew naught but peace and prosperity. Until it was faced with a crisis, unprecedented, terrifying. Civilization found itself perched upon a precipice, staring into oblivion. But through prayer and sacrifice, the will of the star was made manifest. Zodiac was his name, and by his grace was the calamity averted.
Zodiac.
A savior mighty and magnificent, deserving of reverence and gratitude. One would have thought, yet some thought otherwise. From the fears of these naysayers would rise Hydaelyn, she who was to serve as his shackles, to bind him and hold him in check. And so they fought, and they fought, and they fought, and in the end, Hydaelyn was victorious. With all her strength, she smote him, dealing a blow so devastating that it split the very fabric of reality. And thus was Zodiac banished and his being divided. That concludes today's lesson on long-forgotten history. Though I imagine your mother would offer a rather contradictory account, as is her wont.
I'm sorry, I can only assume I misheard. But it sounded an awful lot like you were implying both Zodiac and Hydaelyn are not gods. But...
what? Not gods of the first? Is that what you thought these paintings depicted? Or... oh. They are gods after a fashion, yes. But no different from the kind with which you are so intimately acquainted. Formed of faith and prayer, of conviction and devotion. The eldest and most powerful of primals.
You have spun quite a tale. Yet you have not explained the role of the Asians in all of this. How is it you are privy to ancient secrets lost to time?
Finally, finally you ask the right question. And shrewd questions warrant honest answers. We Asians know because it is our history, our story. It was we who summoned Zodiac, we natives of that sundered paradise. Now, do you see why we yearn for the great rejoining? For our world, for our people, for all creation to be made whole again. Wouldn't you wish for the same?